Welcome at my channel Acreates, the channel for game tutorials and more. In this tutorial we implement a key and a door to show how to make a smooth level transition. I will continue with the content from the double jump tutorial from last week, so if you get stuck, just rewatch that one first. First we will delete the key image and make a new 2D scene to make a functional key instead. Change the node into an area 2D node, give it a sprite as a child and a collision shape 2D node. Drag in the key sprite, select a rectangle shape for the collision and adjust its size as you wish. Before we continue, I do like to explain how we can organize everything before we feel overwhelmed. Click on the file system and create three new folders, one for the scripts, scenes and sprites. Drag over your files in the corresponding folder and we can continue. Now we also can neatly drag in two sprites in the folder, one for the door being open and one for being closed. You can use any door image. Don't forget to save the scene for the key and make a new scene for the door. Change its node into an area 2D and rename as door. Add an animated sprite in a collision shape 2D as its child. Click on the door animation and select new sprite frames and click on edit. Drag in the closed door in the closed animation and the open door in the new animation we call open. Recheck on the animation if the closed door is selected. This means that this is the default animation of the door. If necessary, you can also rescale the door image under the transform tab. For the collision shape 2D, we select the new rectangle shape and adjust its size. Okay, let's add a new script on the door and save the scene. Go back to the level scene, click on the level node and link the key to the scene and place it on top of the platform. Click again on the level node to be sure the door will be not a child of the key and link the door into the scene. Place the door in the right corner. Drag both the key and the door in top of the child order of the level node to set the player always in front of the two objects. On the key we will click on the node functions and select body entered and connect this with the player. On top of the player script we will add a new variable for the key and I will use it as a boolean so it will set its starting value to false. On the linked function on underscore key underscore body underscore entered, we will set the key value to true and use get underscore node and drag in the key scene and delete the key with Q3. Let's just enjoy this moment and test if this function is working. For the door we will do the same and link the body underscore entered of the door with the player script and on top of the script we will add the signal named door open. In the onDoorBodyEntered function we will check if the key is true. If the key is true, then we will activate the signal doorOpen with the emit underscore signal. And to add some animation in, we want to set a bit of a delay before we will close the door again. So we also set the yieldTree underscore createTimer of 0.5 with a timeout function. Click on the player node on the left side and connect the new signal doorOpen with our script on the door. This is the reason why we already created the script for the door, otherwise you can't select the door script. In this new function we'll set the door animation open to play. We set another timer with yield create timer timeout. And after the timer we'll set the door animation back to its default, the closed door. Start the scene and check if your door animation is working before we make the new level. Before making a new level I like to reuse the platform, so I want to automatically recreate the scene out of our object. Click on the platform with your right mouse button to make it a scene. Click new scene, rename the node as level 2 and link in the platform and another platform on it and resize its size and place it somewhere else to make a new level. Add in the door and the key as well. Before we can add in the player in the scene, be sure to check in your player scene if you attach the player script. If not, go back to the player scene and add the player script on the player. Now we can get back to level 2 to add in the player into the scene and give it a nice starting position within our new level. Now that we have created level 2, we can go back in the player script and under the timer in the body entered, we can change our main scene into level 2. Let's check as well to see if this transition is working perfectly. And it does! Nice job! We are almost there. The only thing we really need to do is in level 2 to activate all the nodes and the signals by clicking on the body entered and connect it to the right script. We don't need to redo any code, just be sure to connect all the signals. The transition should work fine now. I hope you learned some new nice tricks in this tutorial. If so, don't forget to like and subscribe for new content. This was Acreates, have a nice week, make more, enjoy more.